Welcome back to the National Sports Centre in Sophia Gardens, Cardiff. British title action is coming your way next. Robbie Regan, the local boy from Kefen Forest, and Joe Kelly from Glasgow. Joe Kelly, the IBF Intercontinental Champion, and fighting for the title, vacated by Pat Clinton of Crawley. This is Joe Kelly from Glasgow. And in a great tradition of Scottish flyweights, going back to perhaps one of the great flyweight champions of the world of the 20th century, Benny Lynch. Got a wise old bird in his corner in the shape of Paddy Byrne. Only little man, Joe Kelly, 5 foot one and a half. Kelly in, appropriately enough, Kelly Green. There's Paddy Byrne there, been around a long time. And the cheer you will hear for Robbie Regan. See, he's had roughly a third of the number of fights that Kelly has had, but my word, he wants this one, and who's to say he's not ready? So, the national anthems now. Scotland and Wales. And the strains of Scotland the Brave. Together, you've got a crowd. Put Welshmen together, you've got a choir.
Singing like that, it was tough for me when my dad sang Danny Boy, and I know it must be tough for him too, but he's ready, he looks in tremendous shape, and so does Kelly. This is going to be a good fight.
3 minute rounds to decide the Vacant Flyweight Championship of Great Britain. Between
Regan's announcement, getting drowned by the crowd. Well, Joe Kelly bang on the flyweight championship limit of 8 stone. Robbie Regan, 7 stone, 13 and 3/4. 4 ounces inside the limit. Regan got a height advantage, not much, but enough. Now, remember, Kelly lost last time out in February against Salvatore Fanni in Italy for the vacant European title, and it remains to be seen how much that stoppage loss has affected him. 12 rounds for the vacant flyweight championship of Great Britain. Regan in the gold, Kelly in the green.
He's always had trouble, Kelly, because of the fact that he's short. He's always had to be the aggressor, and he's going to have to do the same with Regan. Regan's a very tidy, sharp little guy. You know, some people say it's too early in his career to be fighting for a British title. Remember that Charlie Magri, on his third professional fight, fought for the British flyweight title. And flyweights generally, look at the guys from the Orient, haven't had fought for titles like at half a dozen fights and what have you. So world title fights at half a dozen fights. So this guy, it's not too early for him. It's just right. He's ready. He's in great shape. And this is his big chance. Fighting for the British title in front of his home fans, he's got a hell of a chance.
Dave Paris, the referee, vastly experienced.
Immediately I noticed that Kelly looks slow. His punches are sort of 3/4 the speed of Regan. Regan's is much quicker and sharper. That's a problem, because he's got to come forward. He's a solid little man and punches his weight, but he does stop a lot of shots. Reagan's got to be careful. He's got to move around. Outbox Kelly, not come forward and take control of the ring from the centre of the ring, and take control of the fight from the centre of the ring, and just move around Kelly and outbox him for the first few rounds at least before he starts trading with him, because Kelly will be dangerous in these early rounds. Kelly, on the other hand, I feel should be coming forward, trying to take the fight to Regan, push him back, and, you know, a man with those short, solid hooks that he has, move his head and get lunging him with those left hooks, because that's his best chance. Regan should be flicking that left jab more. Good opening round, even Stevens.
Well, Robbie Regan boxing with confidence in that opening session, and you cannot get away from the feeling, Barry, that Kelly maybe lost an opportunity then of showing Regan exactly what life was all about at this level by going out with a bang right from the first bell and being the governor.
Yes, and putting the fear of God into him, just rushing straight out there. When you've got that sort of power that he has, you've got to rush out. If the guy's a light puncher like Regan is not a great puncher, he's a lightish hitter, throws his punches in combinations and wears his opponents down. What Kelly should have done there was walk straight out and whack him, hit him with a good solid punch, put the fear of God in him, get him on the move, take control of the centre of the ring. Instead, he allowed Regan to take control of the centre of the ring.
Kelly, the IBF Intercontinental Champion, that title not at stake tonight. Just British, honours up for grabs. Regan in the gold, undefeated as a professional. 4 wins, 3 draws. but he has never met anyone, with all due respect to his opponents, never met anyone remotely of Kelly's class.
That's true. But remember, he has gone 10 rounds, so he knows what it's like to fight at a hot pace for 10 rounds. And he's in good shape. He looks in tremendous shape. He was a quarter of a pound under the weight. And winking down at his corner men there, showing a sign of confidence. Got to be sharp here. He's got to use that jab. He's not flicking that jab enough. That's what he's going to measure, that right hand, with a flicking left jab. Kelly now starting to be a bit more aggressive. Regan's got to use that jab and throw fast, sharp combinations. Kelly's got to lunge over the left hook and right hand over the top and move his head.
Kelly trying to work to the body. A solid puncher is Joe Kelly. The aggressive little fighter. But tied to the left end. But Regan, as we've seen before, is not a one-shot specialist. He can stop you, but not with a single shot.
That's right, he's got to start using his fast combinations and using that left jab. That's his most effective weapon in this fight. Kelly being so much shorter than him, he's got to land that left hand and not allow Kelly to land those short hooks like he's been landing just now. But a flick the jab, move around the way he's been doing it just now. Flick the jab out, one, two, threes and away. Frustrate Kelly. Look how short Kelly's punches are. They're all short, arcing hooks. Nothing straight. That's what he relies on.
Well, Regan's got to be like a little will-o'-the-wisp for this fight. Darting in and out. Because there's no doubt at all that with his reach advantage, you could out-jab Kelly all night long.
He's taller and he's faster. Nice one turn away in there with Kelly. Stop both of them. He's so solid and strong on the inside. Regan has got to get in and out. Can't afford to stay in there. Trying to counterpunch, it's surprising to see a short man trying to counterpunch a faster and taller opponent. In the round two, that's a good round for Regan.
So we're with Robbie Regan, just having his eighth professional fight tonight. And attempting to follow in the footsteps of the legendary Jimmy Wilde. This is how he might do it.
Good solid right hand there from Regan. And a long left hook afterwards. You see Kelly standing on the outside. He's got to get closer. Regan should be staying on the outside. Instead, he's coming forward and he's taking the fight away from Kelly. And Kelly's experience, I'm sure he'll change his tactics this round and start coming forward and working on those short hooks.
Third round, Kelly in green, Regan in gold. It's a good start by the Welsh boy. Kelly not really got going yet. Well, for a kid of 22, Barry, he's fighting with great confidence, Regan, so far.
Yeah, and with such little experience in the professional game, he's really confident, but he can't allow that confidence to become cockiness, so he's got to keep his hands up tight and throw his combinations and get out. Kelly's a solid guy and he'll be dangerous for a lot longer.
Yeah, it's worth reminding you, Kelly won the Intercontinental title against Reggie Brown in America in the 10th round, so he can be dangerous right to the finish of a fight, this man.
And he absorbs a good shot too, Kelly. Despite those losses inside the distance, he does absorb a good punch. And Regan is a sharp puncher, but not a devastating hitter, so he's got to use those fast punches. and not hang around. It's still a very interesting fight. Kelly's fighting like a real old pro. He's not wasting anything. Taking his time. Oh, that's a lovely left hook from Regan. Double that up. Body shot first, then a short left hook, and that staggered Kelly.
Another one. And again.
Good shot. Regan switching to... No, staying orthodox. I thought he switched to southpaw there. He's nailing Kelly with that left hook as Kelly comes forward.
And this is an impressive start by the youngster.
Oh, another left hook. That's a good shot. Regan is really punching powerfully tonight. Surprised how powerfully he's punching. Got to be careful, but Kelly can bang. Can't afford to take chances on the inside. He's got to be careful. Tuck up nice and tight. If he hasn't the time to get out, he's got to get his hands back up again. That right hook of Kelly's is a solid shot. Watch what Kelly does with it. He throws it to the body and immediately he throws it over the top to the head. Oh, good shot in time.
And Regan just got out of the way of that in time.
It's a good round for Regan. Was well on top of that round.
So we're with Joe Kelly. In his corner, 27 years of age.
Looks very calm and relaxed. There's not no marks on him yet.
Been boxing as a pro since January 85.
Regan attacked for most of that round. Here we have a glimpse of what it was like. That left hook was just beautiful. Hit him right on the temple. Hit Kelly right on the temple with that left hook. It's a very dangerous place to be hit, but it did shake him that one, but he came back well, Kelly, at the end of the round.
Yeah, it's probably just as well for Kelly that Regan is not, as we've established, a one-punch knockout specialist, because he got caught with three good, solid left hooks in that round. Had he been, say, someone like a Charlie Magri facing him, he might not have been so fortunate.
There hasn't been the fighter born, Dave, that can do it all. Leonard was the nearest thing to it, I think. But back to the action here. Kelly coming forward again, but Regan picking him off with those counter punches. So far, so good for him.
Kelly's simply got to step up his own pace at the moment because he's not doing nearly enough, and he's getting just outboxed at the moment. No other word for it.
And he's allowing Regan to steal the fight and also gaining confidence and start taking the centre of the ring. Maybe that's a little ploy on his behalf, Kelly. Maybe he's leading him into a false sense of security because he is a dangerous puncher and can be dangerous for the entire fight.
That's why, as I said, the IBF Intercontinental title stopped Reggie Brown in the 10th round of the scheduled 12 rounder. So you take him lightly at your own peril.
Good right,
good right hand from Regan.
Nice shot. Kelly can't keep taking those punches. Oh, a beautiful left hook, just right on the button there.
And Regan comes storming in now. Kelly covering up.
Be careful now, Regan. His hands are down by his chest. He's got to be silly. He can't be silly. He get nailed with a counter punch from Kelly. Kelly was hurt with that left hook. That was a beautiful shot. Oh, another good left hook. That left hook has been working beautifully for him. Dave Gardner saw him in the corner between the rounds there, telling him, bring it up the middle. Across the top, up the middle, down below.
And Regan boxing with supreme confidence now. But as Barry says, he's got to watch out for cockiness. The crowd getting behind him.
Kelly reaching with those punches, and Regan just pulling back into the ropes and tucking his hands up.
That's got to be said.
Falling short. Kelly looks tired, Dave. He looks really wobbly there. Those punches really hurt him.
No knockdowns yet. And Kelly's got to start being a bully. He's by far the more experienced fighter. He's got to start roughing the youngster up.
He's been hurt with those punches. He really has. And his only chance is if Regan gets overconfident and makes a mistake. He's really taking control. He's won the last 2-3 rounds, and he's really hurt Kelly on a number of occasions.
The bell for the end of round four. Another good round for Robbie Regan. A break, but we'll be back. You wonder just how much that European title loss to Salvatore Fanny back in February took out of Joe Kelly on the right. He's a lackluster fighter tonight, Barry.
Yeah, he looks tired. He looks slow. And look at the way he walked onto the left hook. He staggered back into the corner. Regan was on him like a shot. But he's not gone completely. Not by a long way.
Oh, no.
He's an experienced kid. He's a strong hitter. And Regan can't afford to make mistakes with him, because he can take you out of there.
But he's got to start messing Regan up a bit.
Yeah, he's got to come forward. He hasn't been coming forward. He hasn't been roughing him up. He hasn't been cutting the ring down and trying those short hooks. Look how much out of range he was with that left hook. He was like a foot out of range. He's got to step forward and use his feet to move his head, shuffle forward and short, you know, throw those short hooks in bursts. His punches are slow, he's predictable, and he's walking on the punches. Can't keep doing that.
Well, in short, he's had three times as many fights as Regan, but you'd never realise that he's got to bring that experience to tell, or else he's going to lose and lose heavily.
He looks slow and tired. I wonder how much trouble he has had making the weight. Remember, he came in dead on the 8-stone limit.
That's right.
So, and he does look, his pants are tight, but he looks, does look like he has a little bit of spare around the middle, so I wonder what his preparation has been like, and has he really taking his weight down in a hurry, because he looks tired.
I think he's fought as heavy as 8 stone 9.
Yeah.
So, you know, that speaks for itself.
Well, it will show up in his performance in the later rounds. He's been slow from the offset, and he hasn't been using the right tactics. It's all Regan at the moment. But we can never write this guy off, Kelly. He's a solid little puncher, solid hooker, and he's always in there with a great chance. Regan boxing very sensibly now in this round, picking him off. Picking Kelly off of that left jab, short hooks, and away. Kelly's got to start doing more work, because this fight is slipping away at a rapid rate.
Well, he's at the moment, he's trying to out-jab Regan, and
he's waiting, Dave. He's waiting on a chance, an opportunity to land one of those hooks, and it's not there. And you got to go looking for it, or it won't happen. Not unless Regan makes a mistake and leaves himself open, which can happen. That's what boxing's all about. So let's sit back and see what happens. Regan's in control at the moment.
One thing Regan must not try and do is try and mix it with Kelly. That would be too overconfident, and in the long run might be very foolish, because his tactics at the moment are winning the fight for him.
Exactly. And he can start mixing it later on in the fight when he has Kelly more tired. At the moment he's picking him off nicely. He's been very effective with his combination punches and counter punches. He just stick to that pattern until Kelly really starts to slow down. And then he can start landing and digging his heels in and landing those solid punches, the jackpot punches that he hopes to land.
Well, Robbie Regan, we saw him win the Welsh flyweight title earlier this year at the Star Leisure Centre in Splott. Kevin Jenkins, he outpointed him over 10 rounds, won every single round on the scorecard that night. But there's a big difference between going 10 rounds when you're the governor and you're doing everything you want to do and everything you try to do comes off. Big difference against a man as experienced as Joe Kelly, but it's coming very good for for Robbie Regan tonight, not so Joe Kelly. You'd think a man of his experience would have wrenched control of the fight back from Regan, control that he surrendered in the first couple of rounds, and
round six.
Hasn't been there yet.
Certainly not.
Round six, Kelly in green, Regan in gold. And Regan well in front.
Regan's impressive footwork. He can move in and out. He's got good legs. He can box and he can mix it. He can get in and out, and that's exactly what he's got to do now. He's been doing it up to now. That's what he's got to continue.
And Kelly looking for the big shot now. You see the way he's holding really his right.
Yeah, he's really starting to come forward. He's got to take it off in the corner. I'm told you've got to do something. Get out there and start working. Ooh, nice left hook from Regan.
Now Kelly doing what he should be doing, getting in close. The arms like little pistons as Joe Kelly. Only a little guy, but very strong, very powerful.
Ooh, nice left hook from Regan. Every single time he lands that shot, right on the chin.
And you wonder how many of those Kelly can take. Kelly cut underneath the left eye. Just a little graze. But first blood literally to Robbie Regan in this fight.
Yeah, but it all adds up to more confidence for Regan and less confidence for Kelly. Kelly looks very sunken around the eyes. I'd say he had a trouble getting the weight down. He looks like a guy that had a bit of trouble making the 8-stone limit. Regan really pouring it on now. He can't afford to make mistakes with Kelly because Kelly will hit him and hit him hard. Kelly is, that's a nasty looking cut. It is below the eye, of course, so it won't be running into the eye. But Regan is in total control at this stage. Another long left hook from Regan. Boxing very sensibly.
Oh, and a good left hook again. Now, how many of these can Kelly ship? Regan pulling it on this round. This is a good round for him. Best round so far yet for Regan.
He hasn't started digging his heels in yet. He's just hitting and moving. Nice little counter punches. He's still taking effect on Kelly. Kelly's been hurt. Cut below the left eye. And he's been hurt a few times during this round.
And if anything, Regan picked the pace up in this round. Kelly can't get near him, hardly. And when Kelly does get in, Regan is so quick that Kelly, by contrast, looks slow and almost crude by comparison.
Paddy Byrne in Regan's, or in Kelly's corner. An excellent cuts man, worked on my eye on several occasions when I was cut. We're looking at Regan at the moment. He's got everything's going his way at the moment, boxing very well. Back to Kelly. Paddy's already worked on that eye, put the adrenaline on to stop the flow of blood, and got the swab in there. Kelly won't be told very much in this round. Just work on the cut, and been told to pick his pace up. This is that left hook. Oh, a beautiful shot right on the jaw. Perfect left hook. Counter punch. Another one again. Right on the money. Same shot, only from a different angle.
To look at Kelly in his corner. He was blowing very hard in that 1 minute break. And I think Kelly realises now that it's almost getting to be a case of having to stop Regan to win, because he's a mile and a half behind on points.
Yeah, I think he'll know that himself. It's just your brain is telling you to go and do it and your body doesn't want to do it because he looks slow. He looks slow.
That was a little low. Dave Parris will have words with him.
Yeah, it was on the board. It wasn't that low. So I used to throw those punches and be accused of throwing low shots. remember the guys have a strong steel cup on, so it's not like it's going to hurt him. Just a wasted shot. Got another left hook, and that one hurt him. What a shot! That's the first time I've seen Kelly shake like that. Beautiful punch.
And Kelly forced to hang on.
And it's the same shot, that left hook, Dave. Every single time he hits him with it. Kelly hasn't put that right hand up to block it. Put him to the body too. This is all Regan, another left hook. Good shot. Now he's starting to dig his heels in and trade with Kelly. And he can afford it because Kelly's been badly hurt there.
And Kelly, nothing in response at the moment except swings that miss the target. Regan, composed, compact, and punching very hurtfully. Kelly's left eye looking a bit of a mess now. And he keeps walking onto those left hooks.
Hasn't brought his right hand. Look where that right hand is. It's about 6 or 7 inches below his chin. And he leaves it there. He doesn't bring it up to block that left hook. Look, every single time, Regan just slides under his right hand and nails him with that left hook. Again and again. Can't keep taking these, Kelly. He's going to go out if he keeps absorbing these left hooks. Regan can't afford to get cocky either. But Kelly looks badly hurt in this round. Really badly hurt.
Regan's doing a job on him.
Certainly is, Dave. Kelly's legs look shaky. His eyes look glazed. And you wonder how many more of those left hooks he can actually take.
Well, you can see the clock. It's been a tough round for Kelly. He's trying to come back, but the strength is not there.
Yeah. You can see it in his lack of speed. He's very, very slow. Just eating those punches from Regan, especially that left hook. Regan pushing down and adding to it his tiredness, Kelly.
Another good round for Regan. Packed crowd here at the National Sports Centre, Cardiff. And they, I tell you, are loving what they see. Paddy Byrne. And you can see how hard Kelly is blowing there. Paddy Byrne working Paddy like Byrne a man possessed in the corner.
Yeah, I'm just wondering what he's saying to him. Look, is he going to give him one more round, or is he saying, look, you're not doing enough? He was shaking his head there. But this round was all Regan. Left hooks in particular. Just every single one of them, he landed right on Kelly's right hand down low. Beautiful left hook. That was the start. Look at the way Kelly's legs staggered there. And another one. Bang, under money. Every single one of them. That's a perfect left hook.
Astonishingly, we have had no knockdowns. Dave Parris went over to check. Joe Kelly's corner. This may not go on too long. Regan's so confident now, and no wonder everything he does comes off.
Kelly's got to show a bit more aggression and be a bit more effective, or else Dave Parris, if Regan doesn't do it, Dave Parris is going to stop this fight. He's looked very shaky in the last two rounds. Even now his legs look unstable.
This is round 8. And we may be on the brink of a new British flyweight champion. And his name is Robbie Regan, and he comes from Wales.
Can't totally write Kelly off, but he looks very tired. And Regan is just doing what he wants with him now. Body shots, but they're all the left hooks. Kelly hasn't had the sense to bring that right hand up tight. Watch himself, he's just eating those left hooks. He can't take many more. Regan should toss in that right hand. As soon as he nails him with the left, he should let that right hand go. As soon as the left hooks hits the target. But look at that beautiful work on the inside there, slipping underneath Kelly's work, turning him in the corner.
That's beautiful defense. Beautiful boxing. And when he's not on the end of the left hook, Well, he's on the end of the left jab. I'm sorry if I give the impression that of this being a one-sided fight, but it is. There's no getting away from it.
It certainly is, Dave. It's all one-way traffic at the moment. Regan is doing as he pleases, putting on a beautiful display of counter-punching here. And look at that right hand just bounced off Kelly's chin, turned his head around, the sweat flew off his head. You know, picture-perfect stuff here tonight from Robbie Regan. Regan's going to set Kelly up for this left hook again. You watch. Can't afford to get overconfident. Kelly is still a dangerous man. We have the Welsh crowd singing here now, so they're feeling confident as well as Regan.
Regan still full of bounce. Kelly's eye, left eye, still weeping blood. And Regan putting on an exhibition now. Once again, as the crowd stand, Paddy Byrne catapults himself into the ring. But he can do very little.
Yeah, all he can do is try and spur Kelly on. Kelly came back to the corner shaking his head there. And he's a tired fighter. He's cut. He hasn't won a round for the last six rounds. And, it's uphill for him. I just wonder what you can do to try to motivate a fighter at this stage. Regan done what he liked in this round. All left hand work. Everything landed. Loves a long left hook. And was in complete control there. Got a bit cocky and overconfident and moved about like Muhammad Ali. But you have to hand it to him. He's put on a fabulous display tonight.
Four rounds to go, including this one. This is round nine. 12 round championship distance. Joe Kelly from Glasgow, the IBF Intercontinental Champion, in green. Robbie Regan from Wales, in gold. Regan winning by a long, long way. Consolation for Kelly that if he should lose, he's still got his IBF title intact. Now, that particular belt not at stake. And he's doing what he should be doing, what he should have done maybe 6-7 rounds ago, swarming onto Regan.
You're too little, too late, Dave. He's coming forward now, but he's a tired fighter. All the fight's gone out of him. And he's making a determined effort, but he's tired, he looks slow and pedestrian, and he's been picked off by Regan. And unless Regan makes an awfully silly mistake, I can't see him losing this fight. But remember that Kelly did win his defence of his IBF title in the 10th round, so there's still a glimmer of hope for him.
No, but I fear it's no more than that, just a glimmer. Having a little breather in this round.
Yeah, you feel that if he made a determined effort, this fight would be over.
And Kelly winning this round. Now, is Regan running out of steam, perhaps?
No, I don't think he is. I think he's just taking a breather. Trying to set Kelly up for a vicious left hook as Kelly walks forward. Almost nailed him a couple of seconds ago. Fair play to Kelly, he's really having a go now. He's trying his hardest, but he's tired. He's really tired. And if I can see that he's tired and looks tired, I'm sure Regan must know that too.
Regan back up on his toes again in the last half minute of this round.
still landing with clean counter punches as Kelly comes forward. He's landing the harder punches of the two, there's no question about that. And he's the lighter hitter, but he's been showing some impressive power in this fight. It's a confident corner. You've got to just tell him, Di Gardner is an experienced trainer. He'll just be saying, look, go out there, keep doing what you're doing. Maybe in the last round, put on a bit of a display for the crowd. But just keep on doing what you're doing. Outboxing him, picking him with the jab, landing solid left hooks as he walks forward. And Paddy Byrne, on the other hand, is trying to motivate Kelly, shouting at him, giving him a good tell him, come on, son, get your finger out. You've got 6 minutes to pull it out of the bag. Sorry, 9 minutes to pull it out of the bag. You got to bully him, you got to get on top of him. I don't know that there's an awful lot left in Kelly. He's a tired fighter.
Round 10. Kelly in green, Regan in gold. And Kelly has surely got to stop his man now to win this British Flyweight Championship.
Another good left hook there, Kelly. Regan just picking him off lovely there, pulling back, getting his hands up when he bounced off the ropes not to get hit with Kelly's onslaught. Watch how intelligently he's fighting on the inside, Dave. Getting his hands up tight. Kelly's bouncing off his gloves, turning them back in again with that double left hook. That's his best effective weapon, and you know, if Kelly isn't sensible enough to bring his hands up, then just keep throwing them.
Regan's starting to look just a little bit tired now, but that's not surprising, the pace with which he's been fighting. But I don't think
the good left
Kelly can capitalise on this.
Kelly landed a good left hook. Regan got a bit careless and stopped a good shot. Got to be careful here.
Once again, the left hook getting Regan out of trouble, but Kelly coming on strong this round.
Regan's got to get his hands up and not make any mistakes. He has this fight in the bag, but he can't afford to make silly errors like he did just now. He keep his hands up, flick that jab, move around Kelly. Joe Kelly can really take a good shot. He's absorbed that left hook all night long, wobbled a few times, but he's still here, still strong. And that telling off he got in the corner from Paddy Byrne has maybe done him some good, there's no question about that.
I thought the fear had got into us and we're sitting ringside.
Yeah. Regan's got to be careful here. Kelly coming on in this round. This is a good round for him.
Yeah, this is probably Kelly's best round so far. His head snapped back by that crisp jab.
Regan's got to keep his hands up. And Kelly's got to just pour it on now.
That's what he's trying to do. And with some little success this round.
No question about that, he's hurt Regan in this round. Regan's starting to blow a bit. Oh, another left hook from Regan. Good punch. Should have those hands up, he shouldn't have them down by his side. Use the up jab there. That's a great run. That was a good run for Kelly. Came back very strong there and hurt Regan for the first time. Regan can't afford to make mistakes in this next 6 minutes. It's all or nothing now. He can't afford to make mistakes. For Kelly, Paddy Byrne still trying to motivate him. Tell him he's had a great round there. That's his best round throughout the whole fight. Came forward here, Kelly landed some good shots. That's it, right on the button there, and definitely hurt Regan with that shot. But Regan fighting very cutely on the inside. There were a few occasions there where he dropped his hands, but he was out of range from Kelly, so was sensible enough that when Kelly came in close to get them hands back up again. 6 minutes to go. This is going to be interesting.
Second half, round 11.
Well, Kelly has simply got to go for broke. And Regan has got to run. Keep out of trouble.
Regan's just got to stay on the outside, use the jab. When Kelly gets in punching range, get his hands up.
Well, Kelly's had two good rounds. Regan's got to go back to what he was doing prior to that. Jab and move, and left hook him. Oh!
Good right hand. Regan can't afford to make mistakes.
He's flirting with danger. Yeah. Got caught last round with a left hook. And Regan in unknown territory. Never gone beyond 10 before.
Can't afford to mix it. He's got to keep on the outside. Starting to tire. Shows tiredness now, Regan. And Kelly's showing his experience. This is a really enthralling little flyweight fight.
And Regan walking on the shots now.
Regan can't afford to trade with Kelly. He's making a mistake. Kelly takes a great punch and he's coming back now.
Both boys are very tired. But I tell you, Kelly looks to have the stronger finish.
Takes a hell of a shot, Kelly.
He certainly does.
Strong little man.
And he's just walking through Reagan's shots at the moment. And if only he'd fought like this from the off, Barry.
Yep. He's got to knock Reagan out to win this fight. He's well behind. So Reagan's doing the right thing. They're just pulling him down. The referee's too late for the referee. Disqualify him. That's not going to happen in front of 2,000 Welshmen.
That is safe to say that.
Megan's just got to hold on, pull and roll and get out of trouble. Not get in punching range. Kelly's still dangerous.
He's got to catch him first.
Megan's come back well in this round.
Yeah, he had a
starting
sticky start to
take control again. Got to use long punches. One, twos, just like he's been doing. Long punches.
Good round. What a good round.
I don't think we've had a British flyweight title fight like this for a long time.
No, this is a cracking bout. And, well, I know what our track record's like, Barry, but I reckon Regan is in front.
Well, there's no question about it. I'll eat my hat if Dave Parris gives it to Kelly, but the fight's not over yet. There's still 3 minutes to go. You know, both guys are very tired. Kelly's a strong puncher. He absorbs a good punch. And Regan was looking tired in the last couple of rounds, so anything can happen in this last 3 minutes. This is a great fight. But Regan is well ahead. Kelly has to knock Regan out to win this fight. He just has to.
And he can. Second, he's got the power. Excellent spirit this contest has come forward, and Dave Parris has hardly had a thing to do. 3 minutes between Robbie Regan and a Lonsdale belt. And look at the way Kelly's chasing him. That right hand cocked.
Regan doing the right thing, fighting on the ropes, but getting caught with a few punches there.
Yeah. the great roars of Regan, Regan come from the Welsh fans at the National Sports Centre in Cardiff. Kelly trying to whip his tired, tiny frame into one last blur of effort, but it's not working. Regan, as he's done throughout the previous 11 rounds, keeping out of trouble more or less successfully.
Doing everything right, Regan. Boxing extremely intelligently, like a real experienced pro. Just boxing beautifully on the inside. They're turning Kelly around. He knows Kelly's tired. A minute and a half to go. And it's all Regan so far. Kelly has got to knock Regan out to win this fight.
And for a kid who's only having his eighth professional fight, Regan has been a revelation tonight. Kelly chasing him. Regan's not going to run, he's fighting back.
Look at that inside work, that is beautiful to watch. He really is good on the inside. Look at the way he's making him slip, turning him around. That's absolutely superb. He shouldn't be having those hands down, but this kid is still strong and still dangerous. Putting on a display here, Regan, absolutely brilliant.
Last minute. And for the umpteenth time tonight, Kelly tagged with a left hook.
Kelly has really tried hard. He's been a very courageous little man. He's taken so many left hooks and right hands, and look at him, he's still coming forward here. Half a minute to go and he's all over.
Last 20.
Regan is brilliant on the inside. Look at that work, that's superb. Look at this,
he's coming. Kelly wobbles at the end. This is a grandstand finish by Regan.
Absolutely fantastic. And by Kelly. Great finish to this British Flyweight title fight.
It's
all the new British champion.
There can only be one winner. And that's the new British Flyweight champion. There could have been no doubt about that at all.
It was a magnificent little flyweight title fight. It was just a superb show from both fighters. But we have a new flyweight star.
That's one of the finest British title fights I've seen for a very long time, Barry.
Yeah, that's absolutely magnificent. Robbie Regan has put on a superb display. Boxed like an experienced pro there. His inside fight was brilliant. He outclawed, outboxed Kelly from start to finish. And this is a magnificent win for him. Well done, Robbie Regan, and hard luck, Joe Kelly.
And let's not forget the little man from Glasgow, Joe Kelly. Not quite enough tonight. Oh, it's overwhelming. Oh, an enormous margin. A 4-point margin. That's an 8-round margin for Robbie Regan. So, congratulations to Robbie Regan, the new British flyweight champion. We'll be back with you at the York Hall in Bethnal Green next Tuesday to see whether Mickey Hughes can take the Commonwealth Welterweight Championship away from the Canadian Donovan Boucher. It's been a wonderful night here in Cardiff. We send our congratulations to Robbie Regan. We'll see you next Tuesday, though. But from Barry McGuigan and me, Dave Brenner, and from all of us here, good night.